Moving on to India, at least 13 COVID-19 patients have died in the country's west after a fire broke out at a hospital early on Friday. The country reported nearly 315,000 new cases on Thursday, the world's largest one-day rise. For more, let's go live to Ravinder Bawa, who joins us from Delhi. Ravinder, what can you tell us about that fire that broke out in the hospital?
Yeah, that's a shocking news story which has broken on television and newspaper websites today morning. It has happened in Mumbai and these 13 people were in the ICU. This is a small hospital which was turned into a COVID hospital, knowing that the situation in Mumbai and Maharashtra is really bad because that's the worst hit state in the country. And so this COVID hospital, there was a blast according to the sources in the ICU plant, AC plant, and that is the reason that the ICU on the second floor was, the fire broke out there, and there were around 19 patients in the ICU, of which unfortunately 13 are no more. The whole hospital had around 90 patients. The Prime Minister has expressed condolences and also, granted ex gratia money to the families of these people who have lost their lives. Apart from that, the Maharashtra Chief Minister has ordered an investigation into how this fire broke out, but definitely it's a very sad story. And all along the pandemic, we've seen incidents like this happening in various parts of the country. In fact, in Maharashtra itself, last month there was another fire in a hospital which was created in a mall where 10 people lost their lives. So these kind of stories are happening, and also because of the oxygen which is being utilized, which catches fire immediately. We've seen these kind of incidents happening across the country through the pandemic. Joyang.
And Ravinda, overall, India is facing a very difficult situation with COVID infections, isn't it?
Absolutely. It's a worrisome situation. In fact, it's gone out of hand in many parts of the country. Here in Delhi, there is a major shortage of oxygen. Hospitals are reaching out to the government saying that they have oxygen left for just a few hours. The government is also trying to get oxygen supplies in place. The central government has ordered has diverted all the industrial use oxygen for medical use, and you can only, like, the Prime Minister is going to hold a very crucial meeting with the oxygen manufacturers today. Apart from that, he'll also be reviewing the situation on the ground, holding a meeting with the chief ministers of the states which are badly hit. But definitely what we are seeing on the ground are stories which are coming from various parts of the country, where you can clearly see that the citizens are actually caught between the pandemic and a crumbling health infrastructure. Many people have lost their lives because there was no oxygen to save them, although the government has been from the beginning saying that saving lives is one of the most important things during the pandemic. But definitely when there was a lull period from November till February, when there was no peak, had died down, we really saw nothing much being done on the ground in terms of preparation for the second wave, and it has hit India quite hard. Joyang.
Grim situation. Thank you so much, Ravinder Bawa in Delhi, for us.